Pre-calculus 30, this is section 4.4. We're in McGraw-Hill Ryerson pre-calculus 11 textbook right here. So you all should be on page 244. That's where 4.4 starts. So I believe this is the last section in chapter 4. So we are going to be having a test coming up again, probably in a week or so. Usually when we start the last section, you can bank on probably around a week, then we'll have a test. Okay. So this is the last section we're starting. We're going to take a day or two for this. We'll have a day or two. We might have a day of review, depending on what else is going on. And then there'll be a couple more days, and you'll have a test. Okay? So you can generally bank on a week after we start the last section. All right. The quadratic formula. Now, the quadratic formula is something that I've asked you if you've heard before, and some of you said you had heard before. So that's great. The quadratic formula is a formula that you use to find roots of any quadratic equation. It's actually like a shortcut. So what I want to do is I want to show you how the quadratic formula is derived, so how they come across the quadratic formula, and it has everything to do with completing the square, like you guys have learned, and solving for x, but not with all of the numbers for a, b, and c filled in. It's just we leave a, b, and c as a, b, and c, and then we solve for x by completing the square. So this process, what I'm going to show you here, is how the quadratic formula came about. You are not responsible for recreating this, but I did want to show you why this works. Because in the textbook, they give you the quadratic formula right here, which I'm okay to show you because you've all seen this before. And I do have a little song that I will sing for you a little bit later, so I'll help you remember this. But the quadratic formula here, I'm going to show you how this was determined. Okay? So x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. That's the quadratic formula. And again, this is a shortcut formula for determining the roots or the solutions to any quadratic equation. Okay. Now, if the roots exist, then you can find them. If they don't exist, I'll show you what that looks like a little bit later, but you're going to run into some math problems. For example, this right here, this important part underneath the root sign, if there are no solutions, you're going to find that this is going to be a negative under the root sign. That's going to be a problem, right? Because it's mathematically a real problem to find an answer for the square root of a negative number. You can't do it. So that's how you know that there's no solutions. But I'll get to that in a second. Okay, so how does this come about? Well, I want you to copy this down, although, you know, it's not a requirement for you to be able to do, but if you can kind of see where it comes from and understand a little bit about how we got this, I think it'll maybe convince you in your mind of its worthiness. So let's say we have something like this. Let's say we have ax squared plus bx plus c, and that equals 0. Now I'm not going to fill in any values for a, b, and c. I'm going to leave a, b, and c because you see in the quadratic formula we have a, b, and c here. And that means that any quadratic formula, you fill in the value for a right here and here. You fill in the value of b right here and here, and the value of c right here. When you do that and evaluate it, those are your roots. So how do we do that? Well, we're going to start by completing the square. So I want you to get the c over to the other side. Let's get the c over to the other side so we can focus on the ax squared plus bx. And I'm going to leave, so that's going to be a minus c over to the other side. I'm going to leave a little space here because we're going to complete the square. But what do we have to do first to complete the square? I got to do something with this a. We got to take this a out, don't we? And so this becomes a times x squared plus b over ax. Okay? Again, I'm going to leave some space there. And I'm going to complete the square. Now, what's half of b over a? Half of b over a is b over 2a. Because it's b over a times 1 over 2. That's half. So when I square this, what do I get? Well, I get b squared over 4a squared. Okay. That completes the square. Now I know you're thinking, oh my goodness, this is a mess already. Well, it is a bit of a mess already, but this is just algebra, okay? It's just algebra, and I'll walk you through it. So what we want to do is, of course, if we add something to one side of the equation, we have to add something to the other side. So I've actually added a times this. Everyone see that? So I'm going to also add, and I'll just show, I'll show everything here and we'll simplify in a second. So a b squared over 4a squared. So I have to add that to this side. Okay. Go back to black. Now, this, of course, can be simplified over here, right? That can be simplified as just to b squared over 4a, because the a on top and one of the a's on the bottom cancel out. So I'll just simplify that here for you. All right. So let's write this as a perfect square. So I've got a, and this is x plus b over 2a all squared. That's what this equals. Over here, I'm going to combine these terms here, I think. So I'm going to go b squared over 4a, and I'm going to write this as a term over 4a as well. Okay, so this is going to be minus 4ac over 4a. Which is going to be able to be written as b squared minus 4ac all over 4a. Okay? Everybody with me there? Again, this will improve your life, I'm sure, knowing this. Okay? But this is a higher level algebra, right? Because you've got a lot of variables here. We've got a lot of operations. So if you can do this, if you can work through this and kind of understand this, even if you have to try it a couple times, this is really, really good for you to have practice, manipulating equations. Very, very good practice. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to divide both sides by a. Because remember, I want to get x by itself. I've got to get rid of the a, and I'm going to have to get rid of this, and I'm going to have to get rid of this. But let's get rid of the a first. So when you divide both sides of the equation by a, so I divide this by a. Remember when I divide by something and then divide by another thing? It's actually the same as dividing by those two things squared. Or it's multiplying by 1 over a, right? So think about like that. So this becomes now x plus b over 2a all squared equals b squared minus 4ac all over 4a squared. Okay? All right, now I promise we're getting somewhere here. So what we're going to do now is we're going to take the square root of both sides, because again, I want to get to that x, the square root of both sides. So I've got x plus b over 2a now. And over here, I've got plus or minus the square root of all this. Now, I can simplify a little bit of this. This is not a perfect square up here, so I can't touch that. That's going to be the square root of b squared minus 4ac. But underneath here, 4a squared is a perfect square. So if I take the square root of 4a squared, that's 2a. Okay? Now, I'm almost done. I am almost done. I want to get this business here over to the other side. So I'm going to subtract it from both sides. I'm going to have x equals negative b over 2a plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. And this is how the quadratic formula was developed. Okay? They said, listen, there's got to be a way we can complete the square and solve for x. What does that look like? We're almost done here. This is the last step. Now I've got a common denominator. I can actually combine these two. So it's now negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. And that is your quadratic formula. All right. And this is going to be very handy when you want to find the roots of any quadratic equation. You just plug A, B, and C from your quadratic equation into this formula, and you'll be able to find your roots. Okay? Okay. Any questions about that? Yeah? No? All right. That's that. Now, let's do some examples. Let's do a couple examples, and then I'll sing you a song. And I won't put it on this video. The video for the song will be on YouTube. If you want to watch the video for the song, I won't put it on this lesson, but I will sing the song, and you can look that up, the quadratic formula song. So let's do some examples first here. Example, let's do something simple. Let's just do something simple, something that we've done before. Let me just try and find an example from a previous section that we can find the solutions for. Well, whatever. Let's do this one. Okay. So 2x squared minus 9x minus 5 equals 0. Okay? So write this down, and we're going to have the quadratic formula sitting right there ready for us to use. So if we are to find the roots or find the solutions, right, we want to find out what x equals. X equals what? Well, what we have to do first is identify A, B, and C. So A is the number that's multiplied by the x squared term. So A equals 2. B is the number that is multiplied by the x term. And you have to include the sign there as well. So B is negative 9. And C is constant. So C is negative 5. So whether you write those down or just identify them and go straight to the formula, it doesn't really matter. But I just want to show you here how we go. So now what we do is we plug these values into the formula. Negative b is a negative negative 9. Now plus or minus, remember with a quadratic, if we have some kind of parabola, we could have one, two solutions. So that's why we have a plus or minus here, as you remember from classes previous. So plus or minus what? Well, the square root of b, that's negative 9, squared, minus 4 times a is 2, times c is negative 5. And you simply just plug in all the values. All over 2 times a, again, which is 2. All right, so does that look okay? Everybody okay with that? So from here, there's a few things you got to pay attention to, like this negative negative. So that's a positive 9. Keep the plus or minus there. Don't mess around with that yet. And now, what is this under here? How much work can we do at once here? Well, negative 9 squared is going to be 81. A negative times a negative is going to be plus. And 4 times 2 is 8 times 5 is 40. Okay, is everyone with me there? All over 4. Did I get that right? Alright, so we're getting close. 9 plus or minus. What's 81 plus 40? That's going to be 121. Okay, 121, which is great because that's a perfect square, I know. What's the square root of 121? Do I know?
11.
Very good, 11, very good. So 9 plus or minus 11, all over 4. Okay, well, you know, this might seem like a lot of work. It may seem like a lot of work, but consider this. Your alternative is to complete the square and solve for x. So it's going to be a little less work than that. All right? So what's 9 plus 11? Well, that's 20 over 4. What's 9 minus 11? That's going to be negative 2 over 4. When we simplify, we get 5 and negative 1 half. And those are the solutions. You could check by plugging 5 in for x and solving and see if this left side equals 0. And it does. You could put the negative 1 half in for x, evaluate this left side, see if it equals 0, and it does. So those are your solutions there, okay? Double check my own work. I don't have the answer. I'm pretty sure that's correct. Okay? If you graphed this equation, if you graphed it, then the x-intercepts should be 5 and negative 1 half, right? So is all this kind of coming together for you guys? Is it kind of coming together? Okay. Quadratic formula. All right. So let's just, now there's other examples, which I won't go over them all because I don't know if I really need to, but let me just show you a couple things, okay? So look at this one. We won't do this from scratch, but everybody pay attention here. What happens if you get a 0 here? And I said that just this part right here was actually pretty important. This is called the discriminant, okay? So you might want to write that down. The discriminant is b squared minus 4ac. That's the discriminant. And I'm just going to see if they... Yeah, right here, okay? The discriminant. This is actually pretty important. It's the b squared minus 4ac part. And, yes, I want snipping tool. Let's bring that into my notes. And the reason why that's important is that because it tells you a little bit about the nature of the roots, how many roots there are, and so on. So if we have this discriminant, okay, if this equals 0, If that equals zero, as in the example where I just showed you here, and I'll go down, apologize. So this one right here, you see how it's zero right here? If it's zero, that means we only have one solution. That would be sort of like the parabola is touching the x-axis just on the vertex. That's what that means. One solution. Technically, you could say there's two identical solutions because you're adding zero and subtracting zero. In some textbooks, you'll see that, two identical solutions, which is one solution. That's good. And the other thing was, and I'll see if there's another example here. No, not yet. Okay. But what happens if the discriminant is negative? And I mentioned that at the top of the class. So do we have it here? Nope. Come on now. Somebody give me an example. Okay. Well, it doesn't actually show. But look at this part right here in the review here. So if you have a parabola that has no x-intercepts, that means that the quadratic equation has no solutions. And it would show up when b squared minus 4ac is negative, that is less than 0. So if you come across something like this, x equals, let's say, negative 5 plus or minus the square root of negative 10 over 7, let's say this is what you get, you know that this is a big no-no right there, square root of negative number. So if you have to take the square root of a negative number in finding the solutions, there are no solutions, and that's what you say, no solutions. Because algebraically, you've got a big no-no there. Okay? So take a look at the review, please. The key ideas, the summary. Take a quick look at that. Read it through. If there's anything that strikes you as being really strange or unimaginably difficult or something that I missed, please let me know. And I'll show you your homework here in a second. I'll just end off the lesson with here. It says, number one, says use the discriminant to determine the nature of the roots for each question. So you do not solve, but you could check your answers graphically. So you can grab a graphing calculator and graph these and check to see if that's true. Now, the nature of the roots, okay? So if b squared minus 4ac is greater than 0, then there are two real roots. That means that there are two intercepts to the graph, two solutions. If b squared minus 4ac equals 0, there are two identical roots, or just one real root. Now here's the next thing. This one is actually tough as far as the nature of the roots. If b squared minus 4ac is less than 0, that's negative, we said that there are no roots, no solutions. In reality, another way of actually identifying the characteristics of nothing, in this case, would be saying that these roots are not real roots. So you could say there are no real roots. Now, technically, there would be complex number roots, but we aren't going to get into that. So roots do exist, but they are not real. Does that make sense? Actually, that probably doesn't make sense at all. They exist, but they're not real. They are not real roots, so there are no intercepts. So you can say there are no real roots if the discriminant is less than 0. Okay.
Thank you.